A new poll shows former President Trump leading Vice President Harris in all swing states just 2 days out from Election Day. The survey was conducted by AtlasIntel, which has been referred to as the most accurate pollster in the 2020 election. The poll showed that Trump is ahead in North Carolina, Georgia, Arizona, Nevada, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania by varying margins. The AtlasIntel CEO said that this poll reflects voters' dissatisfaction with the Biden-Harris administration.
And this lead here is a lot of people are dissatisfied with the Biden administration, and Kamala perhaps hasn't been able to distance herself from that. And so these people, some people here are leaning for Trump. But in terms of the campaign message, we've seen that time and again where Trump sort of keeps coming back to this base, right? Into this idea, more to his more traditional base than this consistent, maybe reaching out to Black and Latino voters.
AtlasIntel also released an overall map showing a Trump victory, 296 to Harris's 242. But while the AtlasIntel poll is showing a Trump victory, other polls aren't so sure. The New York Times Siena poll is showing a different outcome, but Trump political director James Blair has blasted the results, saying they are inaccurate.
All of those polls in all the battleground states, I heard Carl before this talking about the recalled vote, they've set the electorate to the left of 2020, which doesn't comport with what we know, which is that all of these electorates have moved to the right just on a registration eligible electorate basis itself. And obviously we see that starting to manifest in the early voting pattern. So I think that they're sort of putting some cover out there because they're going to underrepresent President Trump's support. What they essentially are saying there is, we got too many Democrats in the survey, we don't have enough Republicans, we know that, but we're going to publish these numbers on the eve of the election anyway.
Sky News host Shari Markson agrees, saying Trump's late dash has caused the Democrats to start playing ugly.
And now that Trump appears to be edging ahead in the polls, the campaign is getting uglier. The New York Times reports, top Democratic strategists are increasingly hopeful that the campaign's attempts to cast former President Donald J. Trump as a fascist will carry Ms. Harris to a narrow triumph. So this is a very deliberate decision to go negative and go nasty, a deliberate strategy to paint Trump as a dictator. This is what's happening behind the scenes in the Harris camp, but publicly, Kamala is pledging unity for all Americans. But Joe Biden let the truth out this week when he called Trump supporters garbage.
But University of Sydney political science professor Simon Jackman claims the election is far too close to call and even pollsters are acting with extreme caution.
Now, let's get some analysis. I'm joined by US expert from the University of Sydney, Professor Simon Jackman. Simon, you've just got back from the US, been there a number of weeks. What are you hearing from those strategists and pollsters that you spoke to? Where's this going?
Kieran, it's an election like no other. I've been, you know, studying my entire adult life, US politics, and no one is prepared to stick their neck out on a call. Some of the people with the very best data that I saw. This was a Democratic pollster, a former student of mine, doing phone polling, which is highly unusual in today's modern polling environment, quietly confident about what she was seeing in her data, including a key congressional race in Pennsylvania, where the numbers were tracking pretty much dead on where they were in 2020, and moreover, picking up a tiny hint that there are a few Republican identifiers willing to come over and vote for Kamala Harris, such as their disdain for Donald Trump. But the overall message, Kieran, after 3 weeks of talking to the best brains in American politics, no one, and it was staggering, no one was willing to make a prediction without any degree of confidence at all.